In spiritual life, the concept of guru is very important. Nowadays, so many persons claim themselves as bona fide guru or Sadhguru, but today we will see that how we can understand who is a real guru or spiritual master. A guru can be compared with a professor in a college. When students go to a college, they don't study their books on their own. They learn it from a professor, a bona fide person who can teach them that subject. Similarly, in spiritual life, a guru is that person from which one can receive spiritual knowledge. By using his own senses, his own mind, he cannot understand spiritual knowledge. He must know from a bona fide guru. Then comes the parampara, guru parampara. It is like a bona fide college. Just like in India, any engineering college must be AICTE approved. If it is not AICTE approved, then studying in that college is simply a waste of time. The value of the degree will be completely zero. Similarly, a person must be knowing the spiritual knowledge from a guru who is in a bona fide guru parampara system. A bona fide guru must be in a bona fide guru parampara. There are four bona fide guru parampara like Sri Sampradaya, Brahma Sampradaya, Kumar Sampradaya and Rudra Sampradaya. If the guru is connected to one of these four guru parampara sampradayas, then only that guru is bona fide. Otherwise, that guru is not bona fide. Bona fide guru must be connected to one of these four bona fide guru parampara systems: Sri Sampradaya, Brahma Sampradaya, Kumar Sampradaya and Rudra Sampradaya. If he is not connected to these four sampradayas, he is not a bona fide guru. He is a cheater. He is a rascal. Now, the books. Guru will not manufacture any knowledge from his own. He will repeat the Vedas only. He will simply repeat whatever is stated in the Vedas. He will not use his own senses to discover, to manufacture knowledge or to speculate about God. Brahma Samhita says, Panthastu koti satavatsara sampragamyo vayo rathapi manaso munipungavanam so api asti yat prapada simni avichintya tatve govindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. This is a famous shloka from Brahma Samhita. It means that the conditioned souls may try to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead for many billions of years through their mental speculative processes, traveling at the speed of the mind or the wind. But still, the absolute truth will remain inconceivable to them because a materialistic person cannot measure the length and breadth of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's unlimited existence. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, cannot be understood by using one's brain, no matter how much one tries. One must take shelter of a bona fide guru in order to understand Krishna. Otherwise, there is no chance to understand Krishna, the Supreme Person. Because the Supreme Absolute Truth, Lord Krishna, is absolutely unlimited. One cannot measure the length and breadth of his energies. He has unlimited energies, but still he is a person and we must know him as it is by taking shelter of a bona fide guru. Just like Arjuna. Arjuna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra was completely bewildered. He was one of the greatest archers, if not the best archer in the world. But still, in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, where there was 64 crore army personnel in that battlefield, Arjuna became bewildered. He was the best student of the best teacher of the greatest Gurukula in the world. In Hastinapur, He was the student of Dronacharya. His energies, his prowess in archery was inconceivable. He defeated many great persons in archery. There was no need for any certificate to be given to him. He was already a world famous, if not the best archer in the world. He defeated Indra and obtained the Pashupat Astra also. He fought with Lord Shiva, and we know how much he was successful in his archery endeavors. Arjuna told Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra that he can control the entire movement of the entire, all the winds of the earth, but he is not able to control his mind. With his one arrow, he was able to control all the winds of the entire world, but he was unable to control his mind in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. He was bewildered. So he took shelter of Krishna. He directly took shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, and Krishna, acting as his guru, removed the darkness from his heart. And by the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, he could conquer the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So friends, let us be like Arjuna. Take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master, so our life can be successful.